Good morning, students. Welcome back to computer science class. So we are in second day of chapter 2. You have got a mail. Yesterday I told you about the features of Gmail. What are the service it is providing? How much space is it is giving to each Gmail account? So today we will talk about few basic computer technologies and terminologies before we proceed to Gmail account, before we create an email account in Gmail and go ahead for sending, receiving and attaching mail. We need to know few basic terms so that it would be helpful for you to understand this topic. So today we will look forward these terms and I am going to explain you in the form of a chart in the coming slide. So these topics are World Wide Web, Internet Service Provider, Modem, Web Page, Web Browser, Website, Home Page, Unique Resource Locator and Search Engine. So we will discuss each and every term one by one so that it would be helpful for you to understand for the next talk. Okay, so shall we go ahead? So this is the chart I have prepared it for you so that you can understand in a better manner. So at the center you can see this is an internet cloud where every individual is accessing any resource across the globe. So this is the internet cloud in the form of wireless wave. It is showing up. It can access any resource which is available worldwide. So how this internet cloud formed, and from that internet cloud how we are accessing internet today? So shall we discuss? So in order to access internet, we need to have an internet service provider or a mobile service provider for your smartphone who is providing internet services. They are having different type of plans of giving internet connectivity. Once you opt for that specific plan according to your budget, internet service provider gives you internet connectivity. Now once the plan is finalized, you need to have a device through which internet connectivity comes from an internet service provider. So that basic device is called as modem. Modem is a hardware device which receives internet service from internet service provider to your computer system. Modem stands for modulator demodulator. It means it transmits or it receives the signal, analog signal from your internet service provider and gives you digital signal to your computer system. This computer system can be anything which can have internet connectivity. That could be your laptop, desktop, tab, smartphone, anything through which you can access internet services. Now in order to have or in order to run internet services after you receive from the modem, your internet device or this computer device should operate on any operating system. That is a basic concept. If you remember in your previous class, I could have told you that computer system consists of two things. One is hardware, which is a physical device, and the second one is software, which is the logical through which you give command or instructions. So operating system is the main system software through which a computer or any system works. In laptop or desktop, you might have seen Windows 7, Windows 10 operating system. In your smartphone, you might have seen Android operating system or Mac operating system in iPhone. Now, once operating system is installed on your internet device, you need to have a browser. Now, what is a browser? Browser is a software or a program through which you can access different websites. This browser could be Google Chrome from Google Corporation. It could be other browsers also, like Mozilla Firefox, Safari browser, Opera. On your mobile, you might have seen UC browser or CM browser. So browser is a program through which you can access website. Now, in order to access any website, you need to know the name of that website or the address of that website. This address of the website is provided by a corporation named ICANN, that means Internet Corporation for Assigned Names and Numbers. This is a corporation who provides you different type of website addresses. If you know the address, if those address of website is reserved, then you can access that particular website. So it is, these websites are given by ICANN. Now, URL stands for Uniform Reference or Resource Locator. Like, for example, if you are typing www.google.com on the browser, web browser, then it means you are accessing Google website through a commercial domain, that is .com, via World Wide Web. So across the globe, through commercial domain, you are accessing Google website or Google portal. So that website is provided by ICANN. Now, what are web page, website, home page, and www? Just now I told you what is www. www stands for World Wide Web. That means you are accessing any website global on a web page. Now, what is a web page? Web page is similar to your book page, where information is written or some resource is provided. But a web page is an online book or online page where some information is given, which can be accessed by any user who is accessing that page. Now, what is a website? Website is a combination or comprises of different type of web pages. As a book comprises of different type of pages, similarly a website consists of number of web pages which has some resources. Now, what is a home page? Home page is nothing but a welcome page or the first page of a website which have some information about that particular website. Welcome page is the startup page. Now, what is a search engine? When you type www.google.com, you might have seen a Google web page comes in front of the screen with a search box at the bottom. It asks you to search something which you need to know. So what you do? You enter some keyword, and when you click on search, based on those keywords, it will give you list of different websites where that keyword is available. So Google is one of the popular search engine which crawls or find some information across the globe. Another search engine is Yahoo search engine, which is also a popular search engine one time. So nowadays we are, most of the internet user are using Google search engine to search some information across the web using keyword. So these are the basic terminology you need to know when you are accessing internet. So in coming session, tomorrow, I will going to give you some more information on Google and Gmail account, how you can access those accounts, what are additional features, and then the next day I will show you practically how to create a Gmail account. All right, students, see you then tomorrow. Goodbye.